My name is Annette Blauwe and I'm a professional pole dance coach.
When I started pole in Latvia, not many people were doing it. It was like a taboo still. But I didn't feel neglected from friends or colleagues. They were making jokes, yeah, they were making jokes, but they weren't like thinking that I will go work in a strip club afterwards. It's just my kind of, what I found a new physical activity that I'm really, really like keen on. I really love it. And I'm just super obsessed about it. And I think my obsession made me not hear the things that people might say, but as a society overall, when we opened my studio where I started working, I started teaching after 6 months when I started pole. And when we opened up, it was really difficult for people to come into the studio to actually try this. Like, even if we called it pole tricks, pole sport, pole fitness, we didn't even have many lessons in heels in exotic. So we tried to make it as innocent as we could at that time, just for people to understand that it's actually a sport. That it came from stripping, okay, from strip clubs, but now we have evolved and it's something different now. There are competitions all over the world about it, and in Ukraine, in a lot of countries, in America, people are sending their kids to a pole class. And that's the parents' choice. I want my little baby to be a pole dancer, okay? Because it's super hard. It's like a street workout, just a pole, it's a vertical. And I had this feeling a lot from different people, from my students, more than I have felt it. For example, some students of mine that came to classes, they wanted to keep it a secret. It was really interesting. They didn't let me take pictures or videos. I couldn't do commercials about my workouts, about the classes we're having, that I actually have people in the studio, because they were so, no, don't take a picture of me. Oh, no, my colleagues doesn't know. No, my husband doesn't know. I don't want him to know. Like, and I'm like, okay, your husband doesn't know, but what do you tell him about the bruises? Like, you're doing yoga and you're hitting yourself so much on the yoga mat. Oh, how do you explain the bruises that we're having here? And and they kind of it felt really, really weird for me to hide these things. Over the time, I think now we have six studios in Riga, and it's not. It's kind of a lot for, we don't have many people here. As many, for example, as in London or and six studios, it's quite a lot, I think. And so I feel that we are developing, it becomes more natural. We have even one fitness club, where is the pole in a club, in a fitness club, which already becomes more natural to people, like, okay, this is normal. But at first, yeah. And it's still, I still feel it. I still feel when people are asking me what I do for a living, I always get these interesting reactions like, what are you, and you're earning money from this and you're not stripping? How is that possible? Like, it's like being a fitness trainer. You just train people and you teach them and they're like, for what? I'm like, it's an exercise. It's just a different kind of exercise, how you can make your body do crazy stuff. And I think that is the where I still feel that people are not used to say that. If you say you are a fitness trainer, it's, oh yeah, cool, nice, you look fit. When you say you're a pole coach, pole dance coach or pole instructor, it's always what is that? What are you doing there? Like, oh, the strippers come to you, okay. I'm like, no. In my lifetime, I had only two strippers in my classes. Like, overall, in these 5 years that I've been teaching, I have met only two strippers. And it was terribly hard for them, because in strip clubs, mostly you see just walking around the pole, just doing some basic spins. But when you actually come to a class and do tricks and do the actual conditioning stuff to make things happen on a pole that look cool, it was hard. One girl, I think she didn't even last till the end of the class. Poor girl, really. When I remember the class, she couldn't do the half of what my girls could do, that are just working in their offices, coming after the office to work out and doing crazy shit on the pole. And the stripper comes that works, that earns money with doing that, and cannot do a half of what my girls can do. I think that's amazing. So, and a lot of people here in Latvia are buying poles for in their house to train at home because you want to train more and you don't have enough time to come to classes. So I think in America it's normal to have a pole in the house. All my online students, almost everyone, the ones that are from the States, they have poles in their house, in their garage or in their living room, and it's okay. So they're training at home and they're just looking for an online teacher because they find it better. It's better for them to train in the house, and it's normal to own a pole like owning a kettlebell. So I hope we will reach that level. But Latvia is developing slowly in this matter, but it is still moving forward.